Hello, everybody. I apologize for taking so long for putting up another video. I feel like I need to explain myself. I have been doing tons and tons of research on Dash Rendar. And I've also had some family in town and have been super busy with work. So, being that I'm a one-man band on most of this, that I end up not having a whole lot of time to be able to get this done. At least, not yet. But I have been working on all the research into Dash Rendar and his family and the story. I have been going over the whole story bit by bit, from beginning to end. This first episode is only the first of many episodes that I hope to do. And I have to flesh out the story from not just the beginning of this episode, but his whole entire life as a child. I have to find out where he was born, his whole family, everybody surrounding him throughout his whole life. As far as is in canon and stuff that's not canon. And I have to try and put all that together into one cohesive story that tells you where he came from and where he is going. And have it match with everything that's already out there as much as possible. There, I have found very small contradictions here and there. Might be contradictions, might just be things written that just kind of don't make sense. And some of it has changed and altered my story. So, I've noticed, like, say, on this initial, or on this scroll, some of this is going to have to be changed. Some of what's already on this scroll is, here, let's turn this down because this is too loud. Some of this that's on the scroll, the last two paragraphs are going to have to change. At least the very last one, for sure. The second one might change. I may end up scrapping this entire scroll in favor of something totally different. Every time I see this scroll, it looks great. It runs fine. But it's, to me, it's too predictable. Everybody wants to do the Star Wars scroll. Every time I see the Star Wars scroll on something, there's a part of me that says, cool, it's Star Wars. Then there's another part that says, cool, it's Star Wars, but everybody's done the exact same thing. It's what everybody else does. This movie I'm making, if it ever gets finished, I hope it gets finished. I will be working as hard as I possibly can to make sure it gets finished. If and when it's finished, I don't want it to be like every other Star Wars movie or show. I want this to be like a character study of Dash Rendar. I want you to, when you, anybody who has seen Dash Rendar or knows who he is or read any books about him, books that have him in it, he's, or play the video games that have him in it, or seen any material about him that knows about him and his backstory, there's very little from his childhood. There's actually almost none from his childhood. But I want this to be where this fleshes all that out. This explains why he does what he does, how he acts the way he does. Everybody says he's just a discount Han Solo. But I want to change that. I don't want to mess with lore of who he is so far. So I have to go back all the way to when he was born and go through his whole childhood and do the psychology of this man and his family. Make it match the lore and what he's done, but show you who he is as a person and how he became who he is. So that by the end of this, when you see that last episode, you look at him and you're going to see his backstory. Every time you see him at any other part of the universe, you're going to see how he became that way and why he does what he does. And you'll be inside of his head, hopefully. And I mean, I've already written some of the ending scenes. Not the ending, but towards the end, some of these scenes. And I'll tell you right now, anybody who knows the lore, the backstory of Dash, that knows what happens in his life, they're going to love it. I'm a fan of Star Wars. I'm making this not just for me, but I'm making this for everybody. I want them to love this as much as I love it. When I see that scene, it really gets to me. And that's what I'm hoping it does for everybody else. I'm not going to spoil anything. Those that know his backstory know some of what happens. But the way I'm putting it together, stuff that goes from the beginning, that you'll see in the very first episode, that you'll see all the way to the very end, everything, I'm tying everything together as much as I possibly can. I've been studying a lot on Kubrick, especially The Shining. I have picked that movie apart bit by bit, piece by piece, looked at it from every angle I can think of. And it's amazing how many different references, how many different ways he puts things into that movie that you could sit there and not think too much on it and it'd be one story. You could sit there and look at it straight from Wendy's point of view and see a totally different story. Or look at it from Jack's point of view and see a totally different story. It's amazing how you could even take the film, run it forwards and backwards at the same time and have certain things line up that just, like, he thought of just all kinds of different ways to make it mean different things to different people. And in a sense, I want to try and do that with this. So I am going through piece by piece of this and I'm writing everything out. I've got the story for the first part and I'm writing the story completely out for every single episode so that I know when I do something at the first part, I know how it relates to the end or to the middle, or how the middle relates to the beginning or the end, and how the end relates to just different parts and different places. I'm going to be putting lots of Easter eggs in. I'm going to be putting stuff that references other movies, other books, other media. I wanted to reference a lot of stuff. I want things in this movie that people that are real serious Star Wars buffs will look at and go, wow, he thought of that. Or that matches perfectly with this. Or wow, I didn't know about that. And I wanted to expand the universe. I want it to feel like a lived-in universe that you, as you're watching it, I know this is going to be low budget. There's certain things I just have to accept. But it doesn't mean I can't make a good story. I want to make it so that as you're watching it, you forget about all of that. That you'll be so invested in this film that you won't even know that it's a low budget film. That there's going to be parts that you will laugh and parts you will cry. I'm not going to make it a comedy. I'm not going to make it just a serious drama where it's nothing but talking. There's going to be action, but the action has to push the story. So there's going to be some good stuff of action, but there's also going to be story. I'm not going to just push exposition. One of the greatest ways of doing story is they say, you show, don't tell. So Kubrick was a master of showing stuff, not just telling stuff. And he let you figure it out. You know, the viewer is smarter than people give them credit for. So I want to make a smart movie that people will look at and really think and really get into his brain and figure out why he is the way he is. And I'm hoping that I can pull this off. Hey, if I don't pull it off perfectly, you know, that's fine. I tried. But, you know, I did get a little bit more done on this storyboard. Now, I do have some things set. The name, the type of the ship in the very beginning, I know it shows a TIE fighter. That's not going to be in the movie. This TIE fighter, that's just a placeholder. This whole scene, just a placeholder, okay? This part right here is going to change when it comes to... It's not going to be this 3D garbage. This is mine. I'm going to have somebody who actually knows how to do this stuff much better, to where it's movie quality and it will be great. But I'm going to play this for you right here. And so you see this ship. It is a... hold on. I want to get the actual designation. It is a Y... I can read it here. YV-559. Okay, it is a light transport. This will be in the film. It won't look like this because this is just a storyboard. This is not gonna look like this. It's just basic. So I'm gonna let this go and let you see this part, just so you can see how far I've gotten on it. So there we go. Okay, that's all I've got. I've only been working on this for a little while. Trent, basically redoing it, three-dimensional one that I had to 3D like this. Yeah, I redid this to make it 2D just to make it move quicker. Because if I'm going to do this whole section is several minutes long. And the stuff I'm going to have in here is going to take me way too long to try and render this out in 3D. But I'm not going to eventually show the entire storyboard for this intro. But I'm just showing this little part here just to show you guys I am getting a little bit farther on this. I am at, 99 subscribers right now? I'm about to hit 100 any day now. And I wanted to thank all the 99 subscribers that I have. when I hit 100, I'll be trying to make a subscriber special for 100, adding in a little bit of something else. I gotta stop saying but I really wanted to say thank you for the subscribers I've gotten. I have gotten in the last several months from, I've gotten from 30 something subscribers all the way up to about 100 just within the last couple few months. So to me, considering I spent years, several years at 30, that's great for me. So I know it's not as much. You see those out there that are in the hundreds of thousands or millions. I'm not going to be like that, I'm sure. But I want to at least put out my film. I want it to be a really, really good film. I've seen some out there, some fan films that I cringe. I'm sorry. I know they tried, but I've seen some where they're trying to do a fan film and they're out on regular streets just with traffic driving by. Like, come on, guys. I know you try some on some of it, but I can't do that. I want this to be really, really good. There is a channel. I can't remember what it's called offhand, but they have it's a Star Trek one. They have a fan film, I believe, called Axanar. That is more in line of what I want to do as much as possible, but I don't have even their budget. So I have to make do with certain concessions, but I don't want to skimp on any of the, how do I put that? I don't want it to make it look like I've got no budget. I wanted to make it look like there was a great budget and that it was done really well. So we're going to see how we do on all this. I just wanted to give you guys an update, see so you could see a little bit about what was going on behind the scenes. I know I didn't really discuss the story, but I don't want to give away. There's certain things that I have made in this story that I have gotten ideas from my son, and I've gotten ideas from my mom. I'm having to do this mostly by myself. But I have some really good, really good ideas. And I've gotten some really good ideas from other people. And I am doing my best to make sure that I deliver for you guys. To make sure you guys have a really good film. It might take me a long time. But I do not want to skimp on any of this. Again, thank you very, very much for staying with me. I apologize for this being such a long video with not much in it, other than me just jabbering on. But thank you very much, and I will see you on the next video. Thank you.